Concrete anchors can fail catastrophically, and many failure mechanisms are possible between shear failure, tension failure, concrete failure, and steel failure. To understand why concrete anchors fail, in this video we'll cover the basic types of anchors and their failure modes, as well as dive into the design concepts. Concrete anchors generally fall in two categories, cast-in or post-installed. Cast-in anchors are laid out and placed before the concrete is poured around them, and post-installed anchors are laid in and placed after the concrete has been poured. Some examples of cast-in anchors are shown here. They generally involve a bolt or piece of rebar with some bearing-like element, such as a nut, head, or hook embedded in the concrete to grab onto more material, and some examples of post-installed anchors are shown here. Post-installed anchors can be either adhesive anchors, basically glued in, or mechanical anchors, basically wedged, torqued, or screwed in. Mechanical anchors have many types. Common ones are undercut, wedge, drop-in, and screw. Depending on the type of concrete anchor and complexity of anchor groups, there can sometimes be a dozen or more failure modes for one connection. Failures can generally be categorized between steel failures and concrete failures. Focusing on the steel first, failure can occur under tension loading or under shear loading. Failure in the steel generally occurs when the anchor bolt diameter is too small for the loads being applied. In more complicated embeds, such as anchor channels, the steel flanges of the channel could also fail by prying open as shown here. This is a bending or flexural failure of the flanges caused by high tension loads locally. Often, tension and shear loads are combined to produce the stresses which the anchor feels. Prying effects can amplify these combined loads too, which we'll touch on later in this video. Now let's focus on the failures that can occur in the concrete. Under tension loads, we can have a concrete breakout failure, or the anchor can pull out from failure at the concrete to anchor interface. And under shear load, the concrete can pry out like this. These types of concrete failures generally occur when the anchor embedment is too low, or if the concrete has insufficient strength, reinforcing, or vibration, or other defects, or if the type of anchor is simply not strong enough for the application. These concrete failures also illustrate the way that anchor stresses are moving through the concrete. The forces generally spread in a cone outwards from the anchor point. Imagining the failure surface is an important step in the design process, which we'll touch on towards the end of this video. Tension and shear loads also cause combined stresses in the concrete. To further complicate the matter, anchors are often required near edges. This reduces the volume over which anchors can distribute their stresses and can result in edge breakout, as shown here. Additionally, concrete anchors are typically used in groups for stability. If a group of anchors are spaced too closely, again, the volume over which the anchors distribute their stresses can overlap to cause a group anchor failure like this. Note that this is not an exhaustive list of all the concrete anchor failure modes, but it's the main ones, and it's enough to convey the general concept of these failures. How can we avoid these failure modes? This is the number one question engineers work to answer when designing concrete anchors. Although a full design walkthrough is beyond the scope of this video, we'll still introduce you to the general concepts needed for design of concrete anchors. The primary design criteria for concrete anchors are embedment, diameter, edge distance, spacing, type-specific parameters such as post-installed wedge size or post-installed epoxy adhesion strength, and prying, which we'll illustrate in a moment here. These design criteria are often interconnected, which creates a multivariable problem for engineers to solve, even for a simple little base plate. Prying is one aspect that often causes concrete anchors to become overloaded. Let's examine a base plate for a post. A simple design may look like this, with a post centered on a base plate and anchors on all sides. Let's take 500 pounds as the design load, applied at 4 feet up the post. When loads are applied to the post in this case, the prying distance is 1 foot, the distance between these bolt groups. This means that the load in the anchor will be 500 pounds times 4 feet divided by 1 foot equals 2,000 pounds. So prying has now amplified our forces by a factor of 4. Now, what if the design is revised to give additional clearance on one side of the post? Say, the base plate is shortened and all the anchors are moved to the other side of the post. The prying distance is now just 3 inches, or 0.25 feet. That means that the load on the anchor will now be 500 pounds times 4 feet divided by 0.25 feet. This is 8,000 pounds. So prying has now amplified our forces by a factor of 16. This is why prying is such an important consideration in the design of concrete anchors. If you know your design loads, product manufacturers will have data catalogs for you to compare your loads to and see what anchors work. More interestingly, certain manufacturers also have design software which allows you to iterate many possible configurations. Some examples of this are Hilti Profis, DeWalt Design Assist, and Jordal Expert. These softwares allow you to enter loads and geometry to see what anchors can work. The calculations performed in these softwares combine engineering static calculations, building code calculations, and test data from manufacturers. We have no affiliation with these companies, they're just the ones we're familiar with, so if there are others that you know of and use and enjoy, let us know in the comments. We hope this video gave you insight into the engineering considerations that go into designing concrete anchors. Engineers spend unthinkable amounts of time choosing anchors and base plate sizes for their connections so that these failure events can be as rare as possible. As a growing channel, we appreciate the support of all our viewers and would be grateful if you could like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and feel free to leave a comment if you have any feedback or would like any more information.